So growing up as a child prodigy, what is it like? Because you perform at age 11, incredible with LA Phil.
According to the standards in Asia and Japan and
so
Taiwan
modest.
And Chinese, that's I started playing when I was 8 years old. So already most young prodigies have careers at that point. But I started at 8 and I started playing concerts when I was about 11 and 12. And
that's
I started
true.
Out with playing in a duo with my brother, who was also a violinist.
Okay.
Now he's a doctor, but
that's amazing.
We played the Bach double all over the place, and then I started playing more solo works. I played Tchaikovsky Concerto with the Los Angeles Philharmonic when I was quite young. I think it was 11 or 12 when that happened, and so I had a father.
You concertized. Your father worked for the LA Phil for 52 years.
Yeah, so he was so nervous. I remember the first time both of us played with the orchestra, and he was trying to lead the second violins, and he was so nervous and hoping that we didn't mess up. Of course, we got...
Well, because he loves you.
Yeah,
so
he was our first teacher. He's a great musician.
What is he like? Was he strict as a teacher?
He was very strict and very old school. He had studied himself with a really wonderful teacher in New York, where he was born, named Vladimir Grafman.
Grafman.
Now, Grafman's son was Gary Grafman, the great pianist.
Oh.
And I'm sure you've heard of him.
Yes.
And the interesting thing, he tells a story, and Gary Grafman and I have had dinners together, and we've talked about the fact that my father used to babysit for him.
Oh, my God.
Because he studied with his father. So he said, come on, Harold, we want to go out, and you have to babysit for my son, Gary, little Gary. And since then,
of course,
my father was a few years older. He was probably, you know, 6-7 years older.
Okay.
But Vladimir Grafman was a student of Leopold Dauer, the great violin teacher of Heifetz, Elman, and Milstein. So there's a great history there,
that's
a lineage.
Amazing.
And it's quite interesting. So I think my father was really a great musician,
a brilliant
teacher. He was. But pretty soon he felt that he couldn't, it was a little bit too close to the family to give his son's lessons. He felt that we should study with other teachers. And both my brother and I studied with wonderful teachers in Los Angeles. I must have had at least 7 or 8 teachers. I studied with Chaspin and with Naum Blinder in San Francisco, who was Isaac Stern's teacher, several other people. But then, of course, notably, I studied with Heifetz for 1 year.
Yasha Heifetz. How old were you?
About 16
remember?
Years old when I studied in his master class with him.
He
was rare, very
70s,
austere and rough, but he was a legend, and living in Los Angeles himself, we had him basically in our town. We had the greatest violinist who ever lived living in our
Didn't
town.
Didn't he form a trio with Pietragorsky?
He had, yes, and they all taught at USC. Interestingly enough, this is
and
where...
And who's the pianist of
the
their
pianist
trio?
Of that trio was Rubinstein.
Oh, that's right. Oh, my
yeah.
God.
They called themselves the $1 million trio.
But
so,
I heard...
And they definitely were worth... To that, by today's standards, it would be the $1 billion trio.
Billion and zillion.
Yeah, a zillion. That's just... Just, you know,
that's
irreplaceable.
Incredible. So describe me, what's Yasha Heifetz like?
He was austere. He was a little bit rough for a youngster like me, but it didn't matter because just...
Is he very strict and
very
old school?
Very sort of a little bit just rough around the edges as far as a human being. But the greatest thing that he had to help to inspire us is when he demonstrated. And we were used to his sound on recordings, but when he picked up the violin and you
in life,
in real life, to hear it that close to you, it was like no other sound.
Describe
I've ever
to me in life what I never.
It
been.
Was no. It just he sounded, you know, like the greatest thing that I've ever heard on the violin. It was just true that basically he had the most unique sound, of anybody that I've ever heard, and it was an inspiration just to be close to him.